Hallelujah.
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 Welcome to the throne of grace. The topic we choose today is responsibility. Responsibility. The word always comes out from our mind, but the dictionary teaches us that responsibility is a duty or obligation to satisfy or complete a task. Responsibility is a duty or obligation to satisfy or complete a task. Or you can say, responsibility is a task that one must fulfill, which has a consequence penalty of failure. For failure. If you fail, it's a problem. Part of responsibility in a church, of a pastor, a deacon, or a prophet, we're going to analyze it in a few ways. So you will listen and you will know that everyone has a responsibility. Everyone must know what to do. If a parent failed to teach his children, if a parent failed to know what his children are doing, the parent is in trouble. Now the world is going up and down because most of us fail in our responsibility. Most of us nowadays would not work but want to make more money. And the Bible makes it very, very clear. 2 Thessalonians 3:10. You see, most of us do not work, but want to eat. And the Bible has just made it as clear, for us to explain it, that the Bible makes it as clear as ever, yes.
Even when we were with you.
Yes.
We gave you a commandment.
There is a commandment.
Anyone willing to work should not eat.
Anyone unwilling that doesn't work must not eat. The responsibility of everybody that you must work for you to eat. Not to steal money. Not to make money that other people are making and stealing it for yourself. The Bible makes it clear that if you're not willing to work, you must not eat. If you are willing to do 409 or to do fraud, you cannot eat. Now, it gives us all this responsibility for a parent. A parent must, once a child is born, you must be able to take care of that child and to be able to see things in the way the Bible sees it. If you fail in your obligation, if you fail in your duty to take care of your child, there will be a problem. 2 Samuel 2:11-16.
Elkanah went home to Ramah.
Yes.
But the boy served the Lord in the presence of Eli,
yes,
the priest.
Yes.
Eli's sons were wicked men.
His sons, Eli is a pastor. He's a priest. His sons were so wicked in the church. His sons, the Bible says, the sons will take care of the house of God. But Eli failed in his responsibility. As a parent, always fail in their responsibility in taking care of their child. Once you fail in your duty in taking care of your children, you'll be in trouble with God and with yourself. Yes.
They had no regard for the Lord.
And if you have no regard for the Lord, the children will have no regard for even you or for the member of the church. There must be everybody has obligation and responsibility to take care of their child. Yes.
Or for the priests. Share of the sacrifices from the people.
Even the offering in the church, they are stealing it.
When any man offers
when a pastor child, or a priest child, or a parent do not bring his children up, there is always a problem for that parent. The parent will find it hard, and the parent will not turn it over to the society. It's a duty as a parent in taking care of your child, because before it becomes a trouble for even you, society, and for the country. Yes.
The priest servants would come with a 3-pronged meat.
Yes.
While the meat was boiling.
Yes.
And plunged into the container or kettle.
They do not have regard for the Lord.
Or cauldron.
They fail to have regard for them. And Eli failed in his duty to put them to the order. Verse 20.
Eli would bless Elkanah and his wife.
Yes.
May the Lord give you children by the woman in place.
Because Anna and Elkanah, believe it, they trained the same way. They were able to bring their child to the Lord, give him a good upbringing, which Eli failed to do for his children. Proverbs 4:1-4.
Listen, children. To your father's instruction.
The children must be able to listen to their father's instruction or their mother's instruction. When you fail as a parent to give them instruction, most of us now work double. Back in USA, we do 3 to 11, 11 to 7, and the children will be left anyhow. Back in black in my country, in Nigeria, everybody, you go to work from 5 a.m., you come back 8 a.m. Because of the traffic, the children will be left alone. There will be trouble in the house. When they grow up, you are not there for them, there will be trouble. When you are growing up, they do not see their father and their mother throughout the day, that will be, except only the weekend. In the weekend, to go to church is going to be a problem. Because you fail your responsibility. I fail. We fail to see the children, yes.
And be attentive to...
And listen to what your parents is telling you.
That you may gain sight inside.
That they may get inside in the church.
For I give you good instructions.
The father and the mother must be there to give, is their own responsibility to give them good instruction, to give them good things for the children to be able to know what they're doing.
Do not forsake my teaching.
The teaching of your parents is the first teaching before even the biblical teaching. The teaching of the parents are first teaching before even the biblical teaching. I repeat again. The teaching of the parents are so important to the upbringing of the children. Yes.
When I was a son to my father.
Yes.
Tender and my
son was saying, when he was a son to his father. Proverbs 3:1-3.
My son. Don't forget my teaching.
Don't forget my teaching.
But let your heart keep my command.
Let your heart, because if you're not there for them, the commandment that God has commanded will not be there. If you're not there for them, it will be zero command. The father and the mother are, you see, the Yoruba adage is so good. They said, a father is a mirror and the mother is a gold. Which we call Wura. Gold is so important. No matter how small gold it is, it's expensive. And if you're not there as a gold, and you're not there as a mirror for your child, who would that child copy? You will fail your responsibility in taking care of them. And then totally, decisively will fail, yes.
For they will bring you many days.
But they will give you many days.
A full life and well-being.
A full life and well-being.
Never let loyalty and faithfulness leave you.
The faithfulness, once you listen to the prayer, what you as a parent has given this instruction, the boy or the girl will not depart from it. Proverbs 5:1-4.
My child. Be attentive to my wisdom.
Yes.
Incline your ear
to what we're doing.
So that you may hold on to my word.
So that you may hold on to my word. So my word might be there for you. So you will know my word and you will do it right.
And your lip may guide you.
And your lip, your mouth. The child will not be able to talk rubbish outside. Will not be able to look at adults anyhow. Will not talk stupid talk outside. Will listen to his parents. Nowadays, we listen to so many things now. A boy and a girl putting urine. Other ones tattoo all in the body. That did not happen 20, 30 years ago. But now you see a child putting earring all over himself, tattoo all over the body, from the face, from everywhere. The teaching of the parents has been thrown to trash because he saw the parents doing it, and the child thinks it's the best, he has to do it. Yes.
For the lip of a loose woman drip honey.
For the lip of our woman, for the lip, responsibility matters. The training of a child starts from home to the town and to the country. The teacher will do a little. The church will do a little. It's you, the parent, that has to do it. Proverbs 6:1-5.
My son. If you have put up security for your neighbor.
Yes.
Or enter into an agreement with a stranger.
Yes.
You have been trapped by the words of your lips.
Your lips. The child, the boy must be able to know what he's doing. He must be able to know what he wants. He must be able to know how he wants it. He must be able to follow the word and the power of God. Now, let me go to the church now. Let me go to the church. The church, everybody in the church has a responsibility. Ephesians 4:11. Every church and everybody has a responsibility. Yes. The gift God has given individual.
The gift he gave was that some would be apostles.
Some, hold on. Fivefold ministry. Some are apostles, which are the general overseer, which establish churches here and there. Like my father, Baba Mubino Shofa. Like my father, Enoch Adeboye. like Baba Oyedepo. Though I a great apostle of God, planted church everywhere, and some what?
Some prophets.
Some people are prophets, but they want to become an apostle. And it's impossible, the gift God has given you. Prophet walk under the apostle. Prophet walk under them and make things easy. The people will see what is happening in the church, like what Ezekiel was showing to one people. If you don't have the power to become an apostle, and you are trying to become an apostle, I've seen a lot of things now. One person with one church, he wants to become an apostle. He named himself an apostle with one church. One parish, calling himself an apostle. Apostle means a general overseer that can oversee so many churches. Like Paul apostles, like Peter's, like James, like a follower of Christ. That they are the apostle overseeing churches everywhere. You see, everybody has his duty to do in the church. Yes.
Some evangelists.
Some like a church. Some is giving us to evangelize. To say, like back in the letter of Christ was evangelists. To say the word of God out, to tell people about the word of God, to make people see things differently. To preach the word of God. Are we preaching the word of God? Now, so many things is happening now. Exodus 28:1-3. You see, they talk about prophets.
Some pastors.
Let me stay with that prophet. Ezekiel 3:18-20. Ezekiel 3:18-20. The work of a prophet. We can see different things happening now in Christendom. This prophet will give a vision, this one is going to win the election. What was that a prophet about who is going to win an election? What was a prophet about who is going to win this election? Or going to win that election? I remember back in the United States of America, so many predictions. Hillary Clinton will win, Trump will win. At last, it doesn't work because the prophet of God is one. The voice has to be one unique voice, not different voice. A prophet for people to see it as clear as a day. But most of us are not prophets. We are money beggar prophets. Ah?
If I say to the wicked,
yes,
you shall surely die.
That is Ezekiel. God was telling Ezekiel, go to the wicked.
If I say to the wicked, you shall surely die.
Yes.
And you give them the no warning.
And the prophet has to give the warning of what is happening in the country. Not the prophet himself trying to look for money for himself, changing the prophecy to make money. Look at what Ezekiel is telling them. If I give the prophet, tell you this was going to happen in the country. Go there and tell them exactly like what happened between Ananias and Jeremiah. It, things are different. Jeremiah 28. Things are different. But things have to follow in sequence. God cannot be mocked. The prophet, most of us are said a prophet, and not mislead the people, yes.
Or speak to warn them of their wicked ways.
And the prophet failed to warn them of their wicked way. The prophet is so important in the church. The prophet is so important in every denomination. But once we fail that duty as a prophet, in saying this right, in taking up the responsibility, in telling people the truth, not stealing money, not doing what is not right with God, yes.
In order to save their lives.
Yes.
Those wicked persons shall die in their iniquity.
Thank you.
But their blood I shall require at your hand.
At the hand of the prophet. Things are now changing. Things are now different. People are now giving so many versions of prophet. Prophet needs to be in one voice and a unique voice. Now, Exodus 1-3.
Have your brother Aaron.
Yes.
With his sons.
Yes.
Come to you from
the Israelites. That is the responsibility of a priest.
To serve me as a priest.
To serve me as a priest. Everybody, like a pastor, everybody has their responsibility. Like a pastor we read in Ephesians 4:11. Hey, that is a pastor that God has chosen it, yes.
Aaron, his sons.
Yes.
Nadab and Abihu.
Yes.
Eleazar and Ithamar.
Yes.
Make holy garments for your brother.
They are we are the holy garment of the priesthood. They are the priests. They are in charge of the priest. Everybody must have what he's doing. And he said, hey.
For glory and beauty.
For glory and beauty. The work of a pastor is for glory and beauty. Once a pastor misled his congregation, when a pastor misdid, was there a problem? There is a problem. He failed in responsibility of taking care of the sheep. In our church, we call it a shepherd. He failed in acknowledging, in taking care of the sheep of God under him.
Yes.
You are to instruct a skilled craftsman.
You see, those ones have their work. Everybody has his own thing to do. You see, everybody has what to do. And everybody must be able to do it in right. Two, we have the ushers. We have the deacon. We have what the deacon must do. James 1:27. A deacon cannot be a pastor. And nowadays, you see, somebody that's supposed to be a deacon want to be a pastor. You want to be promoted as an evangelist. You want to be promoted as a pastor of a church. You want to rule the church and you cannot even rule his house. First James 1:27. He failed to rule himself. He failed to see, and Colossians 3:22-24. When they fail, yes.
Pure and undefiled religion before our God.
Yes.
And Father is this.
That is the deacon, yes.
To look after orphans.
The deacons must be able to walk under the shepherd. Look after, take care of the orphans in the church, take care of the widows in the head.
And widows
in the church.
In their distress.
In their distress. That is the work of the deacons and deaconess. That is the work of the elders of the church. The pastor of the church will be the head of the church. Not you jumping over the pastor or jumping over the shepherd. You are supposed to be friends with me. Now, you want to feed people with solid food that don't even have the God and the power on doing it. Yes.
And in their distress, and to keep oneself unstained.
Unstained! A deacon must be that. Colossians 3:22-24. That's the work of a deacon. Yes.
Slaves, obey your earthly master.
Yes.
In everything.
Colossians 3:22-24. Yes.
Colossians 3:22. Slave, obey your masters in everything.
Yes.
Not only while you're being watched.
Yes.
And in order to please them.
Not how the pastor is working, is working the deacons. How the deacons are doing. What the deacons are doing. The pastor needs to do his work. The pastor needs to know what they're doing. The pastor needs to be able to follow them. The pastor needs to give the deacons the work to do. The pastors must be able to share his ministry for people to do. Acts 6:3. They must be able to have their work to do. They must be able to do their work in the right and the best direction. Acts 6:3. Because the deacon are the one that will give the pastor the report of what the church is doing. If not, the church will fail. Everybody in the church has his own responsibility. Yes.
Therefore,
brothers,
select from among yourselves.
Among yourself.
Seven men of good reputation, full of the Spirit,
yes,
and wisdom,
yes,
whom we can appoint to this duty.
Whom we can appoint to this duty of a deacon or a deaconess, yes.
But we'll devote ourselves to prayer.
Then the pastor will devote himself to a prayer.
And to preaching ministry.
And the preaching ministry of the word of God. But now a deaconess wants to become a pastor. The work of God is not matched up. Nothing is coming out of it. Somebody that's supposed to be fed wants to be feeding somebody, and there's a problem in the church. The church is not progressing. Everybody wants to make, everybody is looking at the earthly reward, which is money. They fail in the spiritual duty in taking care of their sheep. Number 3, 5-10. There are more to this, but because we have the time in doing things, there are more that we're going to do. Everybody has his responsibility. Everybody must be able to take care of the church of God. Not you. If you are a sad man, if you are in charge of the money of the church, you must not steal the money of the church. If you are in charge of counting the money like a treasurer, that they put it there because the pastor must face his work, you are about stealing the church money. When you are there, things are not right. You are about sleeping with people's wives. That is not common in Christendom. Sleeping with your member's wife. That is not an abomination. Because you are failing your duty. Because they keep the sheep in your care. And you not become an adulterer among your members. Yes.
The Lord spoke to Moses.
Yes.
Bring the tribe of Levi.
Every tribe has what, yes.
Near, and present them to Aaron.
To Aaron.
The priest to assist him.
To assist Aaron. You have to assist. Like my media. They hate the media. They know they have to do. They know who has this, they have to do this, they have to do this. The media know their work. The women elders know their work. I tell them what to do and what to do, and they tell me what happened after what. But if you as a shepherd could not get the fruit from your members, you will walk and die. Uh-huh.
They are to perform duties for him.
Yes.
And the entire community.
Yes.
Before,
like the entire community, huh?
Before the tent of meeting.
Before the tent of meeting.
By attending to the services of the tabernacle.
They must attend to the people. They must take care of the tabernacle. Yes.
They are to take care of all the furnishings of the tent.
All the furnishings, everything in the church.
And perform duties for the Israelites.
And perform his duty for the church of God.
By attending to the service of the tabernacle.
Every service of the tabernacle, there are deacons, there's ushers. If the ushers now want to become a pastor because he could speak, he's an orator, the usher wants to become this, there will be problem. They want to become this, there are problem. That's why Christendom is now falling down. That's why there's a problem in Christendom. Because somebody that does not need to go about preaching the word of God, want to preach the word of God. When you're supposed to be in charge of the money, be in charge of the money. When you're supposed to be in charge of doing the function, clean the furniture. We're supposed to set the altar for the pastor, set the altar. That is everybody has his duty and his thought to do. Yes. Numbers 4:21-26. I'm ready now. Because you see, it's a wide topic. That's why I was compressing it just to 25 minutes. Yes. Numbers 4:21-26.
The Lord spake to Moses.
Okay.
Take a census of the Gershonites.
Yes.
Also by their ancestral houses.
Yes.
And their clans.
Yes.
Register men from 30 years old to 50 years old.
Yes.
Everyone who is
if it's qualified. If you say when you're 30 years, you start a war in Israel. And that's what they're doing. 30 years, to when you're going to 55 years, 60, they know it's falling. They know the reason is falling. Uh-huh.
Everyone who is qualified to perform service. To do work at the tent of
everybody God. Must be able to work for God. Everybody must be able to serve God. Everybody in the church must have a responsibility in working for God. And may God bless you as you are doing it. If you're supposed to be a treasurer, you're supposed to be a secretary, you're supposed to be this, but you want to become a pastor or this, and then the church will fall down because you're looking at the pastor what he's doing. And may God bless the church. Amen. Jehovah, amen. Jesus Christ, Holy Michael, our Father and our God. That is here we are today. To know it, to know our responsibility in you. Give us the heart and the mind to walk to you in the name of Jesus. The heart to follow what the commandment that you have given us. That we have deacon, we have apostle, we have prophet, we have evangelist. Everybody has his own responsibility in the church. We have those people that take care of the instrument. Teach us your way in the name of Jesus. So we use this for your glory and only for the glory of our son Jesus Christ. And at the end of the day, we will be in your vineyard. And at the end of the day, we will be seated with you in heavenly places. All this we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. So, Lord. Amen.